Welcome back to Studio 10. We are so honoured to have tennis great Pat Cash as our special guest host on Studio 10 this morning. We've already heard your views on a wide range of topics, but this is the part, it's all about you. We want to know more about you.
I want to know more about me as well.
It's now been 18 years since you retired. Nearly two decades, can you believe it?
I suppose it has been, yeah. I don't sort of see myself as retired because I've constantly been playing. I've been playing the Legends events around the world and following the tennis circuit loosely. You know, with commentating and a program on CNN that I do and coaching. So I've been lucky to coach a couple of great players and still be involved in the game. And, yeah, last night I was out there on the court with Roger Federer. I had never hit a ball with Roger Federer. He was warming up next to me and I was like, I want to run around the corner and just hit a couple of balls and say I've done it. I play with Rafa, I play with Novak Djokovic. It's great to be up close to those superstars. The game has changed, and it's great to watch.
In what way has the game changed?
Well, there's a lot more power. And I think a lot of it is about technology. We were chatting earlier about this, and the strings, the rackets are more powerful, and so the guys can hit the ball harder. A way to explain it is I hit a shot back in the 80s. If I hit the same shot. If I hit the same shot now as I hit in the 80s, my ball, because of the strings and everything, would go about 2 or 3 feet out. Mm. So the guys can hit the ball harder now because the spin drops the ball on the court. So that's why we're seeing these amazing rallies. They're going 20 and 30 shots. The guys going here and there. I mean, obviously, it's incredible skills, but they're able to develop that with the modern strings and the modern rackets to be able to swing the ball so hard. And you know, I marvel at that. I go, oh my goodness, how do they do that?
Mm. Jess.
We marvel, I suppose, at your career and your incredible success. You won Wimbledon in 1987. You wrote a really interesting book, Uncovered, where you were very honest about your struggles during some of those times with drugs and anger and depression.
Oh, yeah.
What was that like?
I think I was depressed basically most of my life,
you know.
And the stress of it all, it was interesting because I was interviewing Nick Kyrgios for the show on CNN, and I said to Nick, I said, when I was about 19, when I broke through and got to semi-final Wimbledon and US Open, and he's just, you know, broken through this year, I said, it just turned from, hey, this is a kind of fun sport with my mates and the kid guys, and to all of a sudden it's got really serious.
Mm. He's a young Australian that shows so much promise.
Yeah, and he's a real talent, you know, and without wanting to pile more pressure on him, he is a real talent. And he sort of said, yeah, it's sort of got really serious now. Mm. And that's when it gets serious and expectations, and you have your own expectations. And being a perfectionist, and Martina Navratilova's them, and we have seen so many sports people and business people, whatever, they want perfection. You cannot win. Mm. You cannot be perfect. So I mean, you are sort of perfect in yourself, but you cannot.
But is it because you were so young at the time when fame began to enter your life that you found it difficult? Is it thrust on tennis players like you too soon, too early?
Well, you know, you go out there to play tennis. You know, I just want to play tennis ball. You know, I just want to play. I want to try and beat this guy. You know, I was an unbelievable competitor. You know, I hated losing at anything. Mm. And my mum jokes about that all the time, but. You know, that's what I really wanted to be. I didn't really want to be, you know, on the front page of this and that. And, you know, if I got upset and angry, then it would be the back page of this. Cash loses his temper, gets fined again, throws his racket, you know, whatever. And then all of a sudden you don't feel comfortable in your own self. I used to dread coming back to Australia.
When
the plane was about to land, I sort of went, okay, here we go. Now I can't be myself, you know. And that's kind of
And is that why you think stress. Maybe for you drugs and alcohol was a way of escaping that?
Oh, absolutely.
And dealing with it?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I won't say I never touched drugs, illegal drugs during my career. I did really early on and I had once, and I talked about it in the book. But in my career, I was a consummate professional. I just wanted to be the best that I could be. I got the best trainers. Mm. I did the hardest work. I think I worked too hard and I was obsessive about being the best. And when that all sort of finished at the end of my career, I just sort of went, let's go and have some fun for a change. Mm. And, you know, that probably... And I did have a lot of fun, you know, I got to say. I mean, but it's right. It's hiding, it's covering up something. And what was it? I actually had to look at myself in the mirror and say, you're probably not the person that, you know, everybody thinks you are, or you're not the same person you think you are. Mm. You know, you got to boil down and look after yourself.
Yeah, deal with that. How did you come through it to the man that you are today?
Lots and lots of therapy. Mm-hmm. To be honest, I have some great people, alternative therapy. I used some different types of programs now and things, and I think that's something that for many, many years I've had to work on, and I think that's something that really needs to be involved in tennis and in sport and youngsters. Mm-hmm. The youngsters are getting more and more pressure, they're expected to do all these things, and they're getting no care and help in that area.
Is that where your role might be in the future, to try to speak on behalf of the talented youngsters we have in Australia coming up?
Yeah, that's what I love to be. I'm really am a teacher. I love coaching, I love teaching. Mentoring, I suppose, and it was really interesting hearing the young lady from the UN talking about that, and that's a real passion of mine, actually, and that's got to find the right place and the right time in my head to do that. But you're right. There's so many great kids out there.
You've been there, you've done that, you know what it's like.
Yeah, and it's not always rainbows and lollipops.
And they'll listen to you too, because you have been there.
Mm, yeah. No, I think that's probably right. Mm. So, thanks. I was trying to work out what my next career move is. You guys have sorted it out.
Ask Ida. Ask Ida. She'll sort it out, mate.
When's your next tennis match?
Tonight. We're playing at the Sydney International. So we've got the old guys are playing, having some fun tennis matches out there beginning of early
evening. Which old guys?
Honoré Leconte, Fabrice Santoro, who's not that old, and then the trickster, the magic man, Mansour Bahrami. He does all the trick shots. So I'm playing him in a singles match, and that'll be a lot of fun tonight. A bit like that magic guy there. He does
stuff. You are such a legend of Australian sport. We are so lucky to have you on the show today. Pat Cash, everyone.